Welcome back to my channel. My name is Darian, and today I thought that would make a noise. Today I am going to be picking my September TBR. For those of you who don't know, every month I pick my TBR by picking prompts from my prompt jar. This, which is actually a mug, but it's fine. And this is my third month doing it, and if you guys have seen my past two TBR videos, I don't tend to finish these TBRs, but you know what? Maybe one day I will, so it's fine. Also, you might notice a new addition to my bookshelf. Look at this. Look at this. She is beauty. She is grace. I'm gonna display this a bit better at some point, but I literally just got this in the mail today. The day I'm filming this is the day that Where Dreams Ascend by Janelle Angeles comes out, and if you guys haven't bought a copy yet, then you guys should do so because it's one of my favorite books of the year. I love it so much, so I wanted to make sure it was displayed with my other baby in this video. So please enjoy. So September, it's going to be an interesting month for several reasons. First of all, I do go back to school this month. I'm in university, and I mean, most of my classes are online. In fact, like, I will probably barely have to go to school, especially the first month, I'm guessing. I will be home the whole time, but I guess we'll see. But anyway, so that's definitely going to take up some of my time, which I'm not sure how that will affect my reading, if I'll read a lot less, or maybe I'll read more because I'll be stressed and I'll take comfort in reading. We'll see, we'll see. So I might read less, I have no idea. Also, I made the decision to take part in two readathons this month. So the first one is Becca's Bookopolathon. If you guys don't know what that is, I will link her announcement video down below because there's no way I can explain it well enough. But basically, if you guys have seen Becca's channel, every month she picks her TBR by doing this TBR game called Bookopolathon. Bookopoly, which is based off of Monopoly, obviously. And she did a 48-hour readathon version of that in July, which I participated in, if you guys want to go check that out. But then she decided to do a month-long version, which is happening in September. So I will be participating in that, and instead of following her roll drops, in this readathon we do our own roll drops. So I decided, like, I see a lot of people already doing their roll drops at the beginning of the month and doing, like, all of them, but I've decided that I am going to be doing them throughout the month. That way, like, I don't have a set number of rolls, you know? Like, that way I can just do it throughout and see how my reading is going so that I don't feel pressured to complete a certain amount of rolls. Does that make any sense? I don't know. But I will be weekly vlogging in September while I do that readathon. So what that means for my prompt jar is that Becca's Bookopoly will overrule any of the books I pick today. But what I will be trying to do is all of the books I pick today, I will be trying to fit into the prompts I get for the Bookopolathon, if that makes any sense. I hope it does. If it doesn't, you guys can watch my vlogs and hopefully it will make more sense. So especially this month, I might not get to all these books because it depends on the prompts I get for the Bookopolathon. But we'll see how that goes. So yeah, so watch out for my vlogs. I will be posting them every week. And the second readathon that I will be partaking in is the Stranger Things readathon, which is, I'll leave the Twitter for it down below because there's a whole bunch of co-hosts for it, but I will be doing it to support my friend Lisa from Lisa Marie Reads. I love her so much. And so I will be, of course, joining her team, which is the Scoops Troop, which obviously is the best team because I love them so much. Like, honestly, any team Steve is on is the best team, in my opinion. I don't think I've mentioned this ever, but Stranger Things is one of my favorite shows ever. Every time a new season comes out, I always watch it, like, in one sitting. When I saw season 2, I remember I stayed up until 4:30 in the morning watching it, and then I had to wake up, like, an hour and a half later for work. That was a good time. I have no regrets. But anyways, I love Stranger Things so much, and I was so excited to see Lisa was hosting a readathon for it. So yeah, so I will be also participating in that, but since I have all these other, like, prompts to to think of. I'll just be, like, every book that I end up choosing, I'll just be looking back at the prompts I'm supposed to be fulfilling for the Stranger Things readathon and trying to fit those books for the prompts, because we want the Scoops Troops team to win, okay? But yeah, if you guys want more information on that, I will leave their Twitter link down below, and I'll also leave Lisa link down below if you guys want to check out her announcement video or just her channel in general, because we love her. So with all of that out of the way, it is time to pick some prompts. So I pick 5 prompts every month because I mean, I don't even complete them anyways, so I'm just going to mix them up a bit. I added some more prompts since last month, and now, like, I don't know if you can see, but it is overflowing with possibilities. And so now that I have this bookshelf behind me, it will make it easier, hopefully, to pick books to read, but, you know, I also have books on my Kindle. I have so many options. I have a lot of books. Okay. So, let's pick our first prompt. I'm gonna try to get one from the bottom. And I also don't wanna see. Okay, I'm gonna go with this one. So, our first prompt for September is, ooh, continuous series you've already started. I just thought of 2. Okay, here's my thinking, because as of right now, I'm filming this before September starts. I think this video is going up on August 31st, if I'm not mistaken. And I did get Air of Fire to read as a prompt for August, and I have started it. Oh, it's right here. Can you see that? Yeah, I have started it. I don't know if I'll finish it before September starts. Oh my god, my face is all of a sudden very bright. We love this lens flare. It's really right over my face. It's fine. It's probably fine. Anyways. No. I'll just sit like this. Anyways, I got distracted. But yeah, so I could, like, carry that on over to September, but there's still a chance I will finish it this month, which hopefully I will. So then the next book that I thought of is Torch Against the Night by Saba Tahir, which is the second book in the Ember in the Ashes series. And I did read that first book in March, and I've been wanting to read the second book for a while, and I just haven't picked it up yet. But I should probably continue the series soon, because the fourth book comes out in December, I think. This thing is really distracting me. The fourth book comes out in December, so maybe I'll do that. Because I think I could maybe finish Air of Fire before August ends. So you know what? That's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna pick Torch Against the Night by Saba Tahir for the continuous series I've already started prompt. Yay! Okay, prompt number 2. Jesus, this thing. Maybe I can move. That's a bit better. But now I'm blocking my babies, oh no. Okay, I'm gonna go with this one. So the second prompt for September is read a book with a blue cover. Interesting. I mean, I could reread Strange the Dreamer, but I won't. Okay, I'm thinking of 2 books. I'm thinking of I Killed Zoe Spanos by Kit Frick and Full Disclosure by Cameron Garrett. And I Killed Zoe Spanos also has blue sprayed edges, but Full Disclosure is fairly short.
Many hours later.
I've decided for the cover with a blue, I mean the prompt, the book, oh my god, the book with a blue cover, I'm gonna read Full Disclosure by Cameron Garrett, and it's pretty short, so that's good if I use it for the readathon. Okay, next. Third prompt is, let's go with this one. Third prompt is, read the highest rated book on Goodreads. Oh no. I think I might know what it is. Oh no. Oh god, okay. Oh no, okay. If it's what I think it is, that is not gonna be good. Oh no. Oh no. Oh boy. this is gonna be interesting. So, the highest rated book that I have on Goodreads is The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson, which is about 1,000 pages long. Oh, okay, it's fine. I mean, I had to read it eventually, right? That is not good for a readathon. So, okay. Maybe what I'll do is I'll try to read this like throughout the month, so I won't include this in the bookopolathon, because like if I get a prompt from the board. Okay, for some reason it was saying, my camera was saying that my memory card was full, which doesn't make any sense because I only had 2 clips on it, so I will have to look into that. So I have to go find another memory card. So if things look different, that's why. But we are talking about how I have to read The Way of Kings this month. So yeah, like I was saying, I don't think I will include that in the bookopolathon, just because like if I pick a prompt that fits that book, then like I'll be reading it for the rest of the month and won't get to read anything else. So I think I'll just read that throughout the month and then read the books I get for the bookopolathon like within that, you know, at the same time is what I meant to say. So that'll be interesting. But yeah, so I guess I'm reading The Way of Kings this month somewhere. Katie is screaming. I knew when I saw that, I knew what that meant. Where did the paper go? Did I put it back in here? I hope not. Anyways, so let's move on. We are at prompt number 4. Let's see, I'll go with this one. Okay, next we have read a 5-star prediction. So I'll pick a book that I said in my 5-star predictions video, because I need to finish all those books. So what did I say? I know I said The Astonishing Color of After, which honestly, I might do that one because I was supposed to read that in August, and I highly doubt I'm gonna get to it before August ends. So maybe I'll do that. What else did I have? I know The Song of Achilles was there and I haven't read that yet. Oh, there was also The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, and I really need to read that. You know what? I'm gonna read The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo because I've been meaning to read that for like months and months and months, and I think I will like that maybe even more than Astonishing Color of After. And I will definitely get to Astonishing Color of After one day, but I keep putting off The 7 Husbands of Evelyn Hugo for some reason, so I think I just need to pick it and read it. It's somewhere here. Here it is. Oh, it's right next to Astonishing Color of After. But yeah, here it is. So yeah, I'm gonna read this for my 5-star prediction prompt. Okay, so we have one prompt left to go, so let's see what it is. Okay, we're gonna go with, if I can get it out there, we're gonna go with this one. Okay, whoops. So the last prompt is read a classic. Okay, I think I know what I have to go with. Because I recently rewatched the Pride and Prejudice movie, the 2005 one obviously, and I was reminded by how perfect it is. So, and I still have never read the book, so I think I need to go with that one. Oh my god, yay! Oh, I'm so excited to read it. Oh my god, well, hopefully I can fit it into the bookopolathon. I probably can, right? But anyways, so I'm gonna finally read Pride and Prejudice. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Okay, so let's just quickly go over again the prompts that I chose. So my first prompt was continue a series I've already started, and for that I'm gonna be reading Torch Against the Night by Saba Tahir, which is the second book in the Ember and the Ashes series. Next I picked read a book with a blue cover, and for that I will be reading Full Disclosure by Cameron Garrett. Then I picked, which I cannot find the paper, I was so distracted by my memory card being weird that I must have put it down somewhere, and I don't know where I put it down. But anyways, I'm supposed to read the highest rated book on my TBR, which of course is The Way of Kings by Brandon Sanderson. It's fine, we're gonna read it. Everything's fine. Then I picked Read a 5-Star Prediction, and for that I will be reading The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. And finally, I picked Read a Classic, which I'm gonna read Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. I'm so excited, oh my gosh. So yeah, so those are the 5 books that I will hopefully be reading this month. Hopefully I can fit these into my Bookoplathon prompts and also the Stranger Things readathon prompts. It's gonna be an interesting month. Last month I mentioned that I'm doing a secret TBR and I've only read one of the books so far. I don't know why. But anyways, so hopefully I will finish those this month, but that will make vlogging very interesting because that's gonna be a separate vlog, so that will not be included in my weekly vlogs. It's fine, I'll figure it out. And I also will be reading The Secret History by Donna Tartt this month because that will be the book club pick for the Winers Book Club, which is a book club that I co-host. Yeah, that is our pick for that is our pick for September, and I don't know if we have a date yet for that live show, but we will be sure to let you guys know sometime on Twitter. But yeah, so I will be reading that this month as well, and if hopefully I can, I would love to get to The City We Became by N.K. Jemisin for Ansu, her book club. I can't remember what it's called at the moment, but I will put the name of it on the screen, but I would love to get to that this month as well. So there's a lot of reading ahead of me this month, in addition to starting school. So we'll see how that goes, but make sure you stay tuned for my vlogs and see how everything's going. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you've read any of these books and which ones. I mean, it's gonna be the Bookopolathon that really picks the order of how I read these. But let me know what you guys thought of these books, which ones you hope I will get to, and which ones you hope I don't get to, I guess. And if you're Katie, I hope you're very excited. And I be sure to, Katie, I'm gonna be messaging you a lot because I'm sure I will have to talk to you about things while I read Way of Kings. Oh my god. That's it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. And I will see you guys soon with another video soon. Bye!